must be mine.
All right, today in the studio we have Mr. Rick Banfield, an old friend of mine, a family of music, a longtime songwriter from back in. When did you start writing songs?
Oh, mid-70s.
Mid-70s. So you were right there contemporary with Allman Brother Band, Marshall Tucker Band, and some really great southern rock that was coming from around the country. But we had a lot of it right here with a group called Southern Fried, right?
Absolutely.
I was amazed when I told everybody that I was going to start doing the show and that I was going to invite you on. I was amazed at how Southern Fried, when you mention that band, it takes people back. I was over at the Clay Cup and talking to Jeff, and he's like, wow, I remember when I heard Southern Fried the last time. They were, it seemed like it was a party in the late 70s. And you just think they get all nostalgic about Southern Fried. It was
absolutely
a phenomenal rock band from that time. Give me a list of songs that you wrote for Southern Fried that you recorded that you guys did live. And
okay. Actually, not very many back then. I've written several since then, too. One of them was called The Softness of Your Skin, and that's on our album. We did do an album. And then another one is called Six Night Blues, which I wrote about playing six nights a week for about a year and a half. And it was good, but then again, it got old and got bad. You know, I mean, was just tired of the everything, you know, everyday deal and all that. So
we talked a little bit earlier about how receptive your bandmates were to doing original music, and you said they just jumped on it like white on rice.
They jumped right on it.
Were there any ever songs that you guys went, no, we're gonna scrap that? When you was there any ever thing where you really wanted to put one on and it just didn't make the cut?
That never ever happened. We all welcomed each other's songs.
That's great.
The only scrapping that was being done was when we did our album, scrapping ones that there wasn't room for on there.
That's tough. That's always got to be, the cutting floor has got to be hard. Let's talk about the song that you're going to do today. Tell us about it's about your hometown of Paola?
Paola, Kansas. Paola's in my heart. That's a fact.
Paola, Kansas. What year was the town, was the song set in?
What year what?
What year? When we listen to this song, what year are we looking at Paola? Are we looking from your high school days?
Yes, absolutely. Okay, so I was a kid.
Around what year would that be?
Oh, my gosh. Probably... mid to late 60s.
Mid to late 60s.
Yeah, my memories from there and all the way up through high school. And I was on the east side of town and watched them walk on the moon down at Kaiser's bicycle shop.
So are you emotionally attached to all the songs you write, or just a few of them?
Absolutely.
So you are emotionally attached.
Absolutely. I don't have a favorite.
Yeah. So when I say that, let me go around the barn a different direction. Do you write to just write, or do you write because there's emotions that you're trying to release into your music?
Definitely the emotions.
Okay.
And obviously, I mean, not all songs, all of my songs started off with emotions.
Yeah.
Because you have, you have to have a good melody. And, you know, that's the concentration, finding a melody in your head. And then when you start writing the lyrics, you have to phrase it with the melody in your head. And it changes a little bit, but the overall melody, original melody you hear, is always there. The emotions come as the song progresses.
Oh, my good friend, Mom, just like my mother.
So looking back on all your songs, what would be the line? So if there were a line from your songs that would have impressed you with the songwriter, regardless of who it was, but one that you wrote, what would that line out on? What song and what line would that be?
Yeah, boy, you're putting me on the crunch here. That's kind of a tough one. Of course, I want to say every line, but you can't do that.
Yeah.
And you know, as far as the one particular line, there's lines that lead up to that that make that the best line. And I'm going to say it's a song I wrote about the band called Trigger Mountain that I quit to join Southern Fried.
Okay.
Well, okay, I'll lead up to the line. Then one day a stranger rode in, and those outlaws said to Liv, "You better turn and run," and here's the line. But he drew first and shot them all before the first he shot could fall.
One day a stranger rode in, those outlaws said to Liv, "You better turn and run." But he drew first and shot them all before the first he shot could fall.
That's fast.
That's very descriptive story.
And I always thought that was pretty clever.
That is.
I mean, not that you pat yourself on the back, and I never do that, but I always liked that line.
There are some that they just stick with you. Where I agree with you about the building up, and it's framed around that one. But there are lines that come out where you go, I like the creativity of that.
Right.
I like the picture that those words paint.
Right.
And as a songwriter, so we're not going to get into age. You got a little silver going on in your hair and everything. But if you were looking at a songwriter who were say 13 or 14 years old, that's starting his creative journey, what would you tell that songwriter? What tips would you give him, or advice would you give as a guy that's been writing all his life?
Don't try to make a perfect song.
Just let him
get
flow.
Get your melody, have your chord progression, and your lyrics. And if you're happy with all of that, then the song will develop the more you play.
Oh, I definitely agree.
You'll change things. Most of my songs, I don't sing exactly the same.
What about playing your songs live? Is that something that you? I make a living covering other great musician stuff, but I'm always so honored when somebody says, "Hey, do something original," that I like to bring it out. What about covering doing your own songs live? Do you like to do full sets of your original stuff, or do you mingle them with other songs that people are familiar with?
Oh, I like to mingle.
Yeah.
Oh, absolutely. Because a lot of those mingling songs have made me do what I do.
Yeah.
You know,
all
of that background is just stuck up in there and never go away.
Yeah.
You know, helps me with my songs.
Well, hey, I thank you so much for coming in today. I look forward, we're going to get reset here in just a minute, and we're going to get you in the studio and actually record some tracks. Again, we have Rick Banfield with us, and he is guinea pig number one for what hopefully will become a weekly show here at Hobo Springs. Thank you all for watching, and stay tuned. We're going to get his recording done here in just a minute.
Well, this is a song about my hometown in Paola, Kansas, a small town I was blessed to grow up in. I hope this touches base with a lot of you that grew up in a small town like I did, and I call the song Roots. I was in the fourth grade at the North School when JFK got shot. I was on the east side of town and watched them walk on the moon down at Kaiser's bicycle shop. And down south, the ball fields are still there, where I played Babe Ruth and Little League. Out west, they still got them big old grain elevators, which is a dig for worms and go fishing. Out in Bull Creek. My first real job was pumping gas and fixing tires up at Quail Horse 66. Used to get a tenderloin across the street at Frank's Tavern. Man, those things were big. Used to drive around the square at night, going one direction, and then the other. Oh, my good friend, Mom, just like my mother, this town I still I call it home. That's where I come from. My roots feel strong, so strong when I go back. Payola's in my heart. That's a fact. I was baptized at the First Baptist Church by the old high school. Used to walk down to Wallace Park. They had that great big old slide down at Katie's swimming pool. And those keg parties out the lake, drinking that 3-2 Kansas beer out of plastic cups. I wouldn't trade growing up here, not for a million bucks. That town I still call it home. Yes, I do. That's where I come from. My roots feel strong, so strong when I go back. Paola's in my heart. Yeah, that's a fact. Paola's in my heart. That's a fact.